are seeing here in continuity the synthetic applications of organozinc compound. Okay, in previous lecture we are seeing functional group we are synthesized such as ketone, hydrocarbons, okay, higher alkanes. So and in today's lecture we are seeing some functional group or new applications such as synthesis of fatty acids or their esters. Again, one reaction is there, Bukowski reaction. Through this reaction, we are seeing the synthesis of beta hydroxyester. Okay. So from this, you understand which compounds we can synthesize from when we use this organometallic compounds. Okay. First of all, we are studying here synthesis of fatty acid or their esters from the organozinc compound. Okay. You know that when we prepare the organozinc compound, we are preparing two compounds. First one is the alkyl zinc halide. Okay, its example is methyl zinc chloride. Okay, and after that, final product we are obtaining when two molecules of alkyl zinc chloride is treated with each other, we are obtaining dialkyl zinc. Okay, so for this reaction, we are taking here alkyl zinc halide. Okay. So we are taking one example, or here how these fatty acids are synthesized. First reaction we are synthesizing here, synthesis of fatty acids from alkyl zinc halide.
Necessary to write
all these things. Okay. So what is the product here? CH3 C double bond O. You can say this is the substitution here. CH3 are substituted instead of chlorine. Okay, and removal of chlorine is happened. So CH3 C double bond O, CH2 C double bond O, CH3. Okay, what is the name of this compound? Ethyl acetoacetate. So in this way, you can synthesize the ethyl acetoacetate. Okay, if in laboratory or any where this compound you want to synthesize, this is one of the method to synthesize the ethyl acetoacetate. Okay, and another brand product is zinc chloride, ZnCl. Okay. So in exams there are number of reactions are given before after the these reactions is as we here synthesize the fatty acid. This is not the acids. Okay, we can write here another reagent so that we are synthesizing it. Okay, you know that in ethyl acetoacetate this is the ketone and sorry, my thing is remained COOED. Okay, this is the ketone and this is the ester. Okay, when we use here reduction or reducing agent zinc amalgam in HCl, this is the reducing agent. It reduces the ketone. It does not reduce the ester. I think you have studied this type of reaction in 12th class. Okay, so what is the product? After reduction, what happened here? CH2 carbonyl is reduced and here CH2 group is come. CH3, CH2, CH2, C double bond O, OH. Okay, now there is only one functional group. It is the ester, and we are synthesizing here acid or ester. So it is a if long chain is there, so we can say that it is the fatty esters. Okay, if we want to synthesize the acid from this ester, what we have done here? Hydrolysis of ester. So if we have done here the hydrolysis by using any acid or base, we are getting here CH3, CH2, CH2, C double bond O, OH. That is acid, and this is ester. So in this way, we are synthesizing acid or ester from the reaction of methyl zinc chloride with the acid chloride ester. Okay, I think you are understanding how we are synthesizing different number kinds of organic compounds into the laboratory. Okay, and again we are studying here one reaction. Its name is Lipovsky reaction. It's most important reaction and always asked into the exam. So I think it's the most important reaction. And through this reaction we are synthesizing here beta hydroxy ester. Okay. So second reaction is Lipovsky. For synthesizing the beta hydroxy ester, you must know the actually the reactant. Okay, always remember the reactant product we will get after the mechanism. It is the very simple, but reactant must be know which reactant we are used here. We will see here the organo zinc compound. So there is the zinc metal into the reaction. It is the compulsory one. First one. Acid in this reaction, aldehyde or ketone is reacted with alpha halo ester. In presence of zinc in ether or benzene, it gives the additive products. This additive product again the decomposed by when we use the acid. Okay, and we get the beta hydroxy ester after the hydrolysis, you can say here. So we are seeing the reaction first. So I am writing here the heavy part for the convenience. Aldehyde or ketone is reacted with alpha halo ester. presence of zinc, tin, ether or benzene. Firstly, organo-zinc compound is formed. Then it reacts with carbonyl group, that is C double bond 4 of aldehyde or ketone. Okay. Form additive product. Of the reaction, I am writing reaction. Actually, in every case, I am not writing this type of theory part into the reaction, but in theory paper, you must write the theory part as well as the reactions. Okay, so what is the actually the reactions of this theory part? It is actually the reactions. Okay, what you've done. Okay, this is only writing in the form of text here. So we are writing the reaction now. And if you are preparing the notes, it is necessary to write all these things. Okay, theory part. Since I am taking all these things. If I am taking the lecture here, this is not sufficient time I am needing to write all these things. Only I am taking here the reaction part here. Okay. So now we are write the reactions. Aldehyde or ketone we are taking. It reacts with the alpha halogen. So general example we are taking here firstly aldehyde. Okay. So RC double bond OH. You can write the specific reactions and also aldehyde. Okay, it reacts with the alpha haloester. Any alpha haloester you are writing, I am writing here. You know the ester, CH3COET, that is the ester, but one hydrogen is replaced by halogen, so it's an alpha haloester. Okay, or we can write here alpha bromoester. As I am writing here the bromine group. Okay, so it is not necessary to write the X or Br, anything. This reaction is carried out in the presence of zinc in ether. So on the arrow, write down the zinc. Ether is the solvent. Ether or benzene you are taking here. I am telling in previous lecture also, when we are using the ether, as there is the bromine, okay, such type of compounds. But less reactive, that is the chlorine is less reactive than bromine. Okay, see size of chlorine is less, so we are using another solvent such as benzene. Okay, but here ether. So what happened first? Okay, firstly organic zinc compound is formed. That is, you know that in this between this alkyl group and bromine group, there the insertion of this zinc. You know that zinc have a wins a metal and have a lone pair of electrons. So it inserted into it. So we get here firstly Br Zn CH2 C double bond OET. Okay, it's this, what is the compound? This is actually considered it's alkene group. Okay, alkene zinc halide. We have synthesized firstly preparation. Okay, we have prepared this organo zinc compound here. So it's a now organo zinc compound. Okay, so after that we are preparing organo zinc compound. What happened? This react with the ketone or aldehyde. That means this reaction is taking place. I am writing here the already reaction. You can write step by step. So firstly these two are reacted. After that we are this group is reacted with this. Okay, you know that zinc have a positively charged and alkyl group is negatively charged. Okay, here what happened? This alkyl group is reacted with the carbonyl carbon. So I am writing here first step. This is second step. So Br CH2 CO OET. I can write this in the form of this. Okay. So again it reacted with aldehyde R C double bond OH. So delta positive, delta negative. Sorry. Zinc. Delta positive, delta negative. So CH2 attack on this carbonyl carbon and oxygen becomes a negative. So what is the product? Additive product we are obtained R CH. Here carbon is attached to CH2 COOET group. Okay, and again oxygen is electronegative here. So electronegative is bonded with the positive one. So Zn Br. This is the additive product. Next to this, what we do here? We get the additive product on decomposition by acid form the beta hydroxy ester. Decomposition by acid means what? Hydrolysis. Okay, hydrolysis is done by using an acid or base. Okay, mostly the acid we are using for the hydrolysis. It is denoted by H plus oblique H2O. That when we are saying that water molecule. Okay, hydrolysis we are saying we are writing H2O on decomposition. Okay, both methods are said here. What happened here? I am writing like this Zn Br. Now when we are add here water molecule in the presence of acid, okay, you know that how water molecule is add here. Okay, oxygen is bonded with zinc. Oxygen is electronegative, zinc is electropositive, so negative is bonded with positive. Here OH formation and here zinc is bonded with OH. So what is the product? R CH OH. Again this CH is bonded with CH2 COOH. Okay, see here from carbonyl we are considering the numbering or giving the numbering to ester. Okay, you know the number here we how we are giving the number. The it's the alpha position and this beta position from this carbonyl ester. So beta at beta position there is the hydroxy group. So this is product which name is beta hydroxy ester. Okay, and another drag product is here we are getting zinc hydroxy bromide. Okay, zinc hydroxy bromide. Main compound is beta hydroxy ester. Okay, so in this way we can synthesize beta hydroxy ester. Instead of aldehyde we can use here ketone also. Okay, and it's we can take any particular example. Okay, here if we want the CH3 group, put the CH3 instead of R. If you want here CH3 CH2, if you group, then put here CH3 CH2 group. This alpha bromo ester is keep constant. Okay, this is about the Diffoms reaction and it is most important reaction into the exam. Okay, always questions asked on that reactions. Thank you very much.